Hello student, I am Professor A.V. Bramne. This is the third article of our unit number 1. Student, in the previous lectures, if you remember, we have seen implicit parallelism, that is, trends in microprocessor architecture. Second article, limitation of memory system performance. So today we are going to learn the alternate approach for hiding memory latency. Now this is actually the part of article number 2 where we learn the memory system performance. Under memory system performance, if you remember, we have seen the latency and the bandwidth. So latency is the time at which the memory request is issued till the data is reached to the processor. Okay, so that is a latency. Now, let me ask you one question, whether latency should be minimum or latency should be high. What is your answer? Okay, no doubt about that, the latency should be minimum. Every time our main focus or entire approach is to minimize the latency. 100% removal of the latency is not possible. But we are trying to minimize the latency in our every operations. So what are the alternate approach for hiding memory latency? This is today's topic. So consider the problem of browsing the web on very slow network connection. So we deal with the problem in one of the three possible ways. We anticipate which page we are going to browse ahead of time and issue request for them in advance. We open multiple browser and access different pages in each browser. Thus, while we are waiting for one page to load, we could read others. Or we access the whole bunch of pages in one go, amortizing the latency across various accesses. So these are the three approaches that can be possible when the network connection is slow and we are browsing on the web. So out of that three approaches, the first approach is called as prefetching. So what is the first approach? We anticipate which page we are going to browse ahead of time and issue a request for them in advance. That is a prefetching. We issue the request to that page in advance. That means it is a prefetching. The second approach is called as multi-threading. So what is the second approach? So we open the multiple browser and access different pages in each browser. Thus, while we are awaiting for one page to load, we could read others. So that second approach is called as multi-threading. And third approach corresponds to the special locality in accessing memory words. What is the third approach? So we access the whole bunch of pages in one go, amortizing the latency across various accesses. So multi-threading for latency hiding is the very widely used and common practice for hiding the latency. Multi-threading. So that means the second approach. A thread is a single stream of control in the flow of program. So we illustrate the threads with a simple example. See here the dot product code is given. For I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, C of I is equal to dot product in bracket get row A I comma B. So this sample code we have to write for performing the multiplication of each row with the vector element in case of a vector matrix product, that is a dot product. So each dot product is independent of other and therefore represent concurrent units of execution. So we can safely rewrite the above code fragment as for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, and we can write here C of I is equal to create underscore thread in bracket dot product comma get row A of I comma B. So we have to create a thread. If you create a thread for this equation and then concurrently the thread will be created for each multiplication of the row with the vector element. So this is a multi-threading. Okay, so in the code, the first instance of this function access a pair of vector elements and wait for them. In the meantime, the second instance of this function can access two other vector elements in the next cycle and so on. So after L units of time, where L is the latency of the memory system, and first function instance get requested data from memory and can perform a required computation. In the next cycle, the data atom for the next function instance arrived, and so on. In this way, every clock cycle we can perform a computation. The execution schedule in the previous example is predicated upon two assumptions. The memory system is capable of servicing multiple outstanding requests, and the processor is capable of switching threads at every cycle. It also requires the program to have explicit specification of concurrency in the form of threads. So machines such as HEP and Tera rely on multi-threaded processor that can switch the context of execution in every cycle. Consequently, they are able to hide the latency effectively. So this multi-threading plays the important role in hiding the latency. This is the main core concept of this today's article. So here you can see this slide can clear that previously the dot product code is written like this, and here we can create a thread for performing dot product operation, and that thread can be executed by a single single thread. Such a multiple operation can be executed simultaneously by multiple thread. That is the important part of this multi-threading, and that's why it is hiding the latency. So what is the latency? Latency is the time at which the memory request is issued and the time at which the data is available to processor. So if we create such multiple threads for every row and vector element multiplication simultaneously, then all these requests are issued simultaneously and the data is available to the processor by the memory. This is nothing but a latency, and latency in such a way, latency can be reduced or hide with the help of multi-threading. Okay, so the execution schedule in the previous example is predicated upon two assumptions as shown here. The memory system is capable of servicing multiple outstanding requests. That is, I said that multiple rows are now able to multiply with each element of the vector. So that is nothing but a capability of servicing the multiple outstanding requests. Okay, now prefetching for latency hiding. So first approach in our example, prefetching. What is the prefetching? Misses on load cause program to stall. Why not advance the load so that by the time the data is actually needed, it is already there? The only drawback is that you might need more space to store advanced loads. However, if the advanced loads are overwritten, we are no worse than before. So prefetching means what? So issue the request in advance and let wait for a page to download. So the drawback is given for this approach that it needs a space to store advanced load. So that is a prefetching. It also used for hiding the latency. How it will hide the latency? Because once you issue the request in advance, the data is available at your end. Okay, so that is a way of hiding the latency. And now a trade-off of multi-threading and prefetching. Multi-threading and prefetching are critically impacted by memory bandwidth. And consider the following example. Consider a computation running on a machine with 1 GHz, 4-word cache line, single cycle access to cache, and 100 nanosecond latency to DRAM. The computation has a cache hit ratio at 1 KB of 25% and 32 KB at 90%. Consider two cases. First, single threaded execution in which the entire cache is available to serial context. And second, the multi-threaded execution with 32 threads where each thread has a cache residency of 1 KB. If the computation makes one data request in every cycle of 1 nanosecond, you may notice that the first scenario requires 400 megabytes per second of memory bandwidth, and second requires 3 GB per second memory bandwidth. So this is a trade-off of multi-threading and prefetching that we are going to see with the help of this example. Now, bandwidth requirements of multi-threaded system may increase very significantly because of smaller cache residency of each thread. Multi-threaded system become bandwidth bound instead of latency bound. Multi-threading and prefetching only address the latency problem and may often exacerbate the bandwidth problem. Multi-threading and prefetching also require significantly more hardware resources in the form of storage. So this is discussing the multi-threading and prefetching, trade-off of multi-threading and prefetching. So this is the actual alternate approach for hiding the latency. Okay, this is a very important part of improving the memory system performance. So here we end the article number 2, that is how to improve the memory system performance with the help of latency and bandwidth. Again, now in the third article we will see the another very important concepts of high performance system. Thank you very much.